said that if the Toronto Maple Leafs lost the series, that I would come back and continue the playoff preview for the second round and recap for the first round. And it kind of went as I thought it would, in the fact that Toronto wasn't able to make it easy on themselves and they would lose game six, where they were losing and actually came back. They were losing. They gave up a couple of goals in the third, but then they actually tied it up and then lost in overtime. So it was a very similar script to game five, where Montreal has the big lead, 3-0, and Toronto ties it up only to lose in overtime. Same thing happens in game six, where they give them credit for tying it up, but then they lose in overtime in that game as well. So game seven, back in Toronto, I thought, all right, maybe they'll finally exercise these demons. Now, what should be noted is the fact that when I made these initial predictions, you know, the assumption was that John Tavares would be healthy. John Tavares was out the entire series. So that doesn't help. And if Tavares was healthy, good chance Toronto maybe wins this series. It's fair to say. And Jake Muzzin also got hurt in game six as well. So he was out for the tail end of game six and game seven. With that all being said, Toronto loses, and the offense has been a major problem for them in these key games. It feels like not getting enough production out of Matthews, Marner, guys like that. Carey Price plays very well, and Toronto is still yet to win a playoff series since 2004. They are 0-8 within that span in series clinching games. So, you know, game sevens or situations where they blew, you know, like in this series as well, they had three clinching games, lost them all. So they've lost eight in a row there. And this is the fifth straight year where they have made the playoffs and have not advanced out of the first round. Now, you could argue that they ran into some good Boston teams in some of those years. You know, the format didn't necessarily do them any favors, but this is a situation. This is a very beatable Montreal team. A Montreal team that actually had less points than the Rangers, believe it or not. And they weren't playing particularly well going into the playoffs, but I kind of knew that this was going to end up being a seven-game series. I just thought that Toronto would be able to kind of get over that hump. Is this result meaningful in the long run of this playoffs? Absolutely not. Look, even if Toronto won this game, I do think that it would have helped them get past Winnipeg. I do. If, you know, just to get that monkey off your back, but then they would have struggled beyond that. Now it's Winnipeg versus Montreal. And my prediction for this one, I'm going to say Winnipeg in six. Again, this should be a series that goes six or seven, and I'll say in six, and I'll say Winnipeg. I think Winnipeg is a better team than Montreal, and I think there's got to be a little bit of a hangover effect with Montreal. With Montreal winning this series against Toronto, it's a quick turnaround where Wednesday night, game one in Winnipeg. So Winnipeg will be very rested. Could they be a little bit rusty? Maybe, like maybe Montreal catches them off guard in game one. But over the, you know, but once that kind of wears off, once the adrenaline and it settles into the series, I think that freshness by Winnipeg will come in handy. And so now it's actually very easy to tell the matchups for the semis. It'll be the West winner, Colorado or Vegas, and early indications looks like it'll be Colorado versus Montreal, Winnipeg winner. On the other side, it's going to be the Central winner, so Tampa or Carolina, versus the East winner, Boston or the Islanders. So it's kind of going to work out in a way where it's going to be like 1-4 and 2-3, essentially speaking, you know, because Colorado has kind of built themselves up as that front runner, I think it's fair to say. And I think it's also fair to say that the North winner is like the team that we view as the full-on underdog, worst teams left in the playoffs. I think that's fair to say. So I kind of like that it worked out that way. And also, if even though the wackiness of, like, let's say a Colorado-Boston semifinal would have been interesting, I'm kind of glad that, like, let's say Winnipeg wins, it'll feel kind of normal. Like the East side with Tampa, or the East Central side, with Tampa, Carolina, Boston Islanders, we've literally seen all those combinations of matchups recently. We've seen them all, every combo within the last few years. So that won't feel too unfamiliar. That'll feel kind of like your Eastern Conference. final, any combination there. And then if Winnipeg wins over Montreal, let's say, and let's say it's whatever it is, Colorado or Vegas versus Winnipeg, that'll kind of in effect be like your Western Conference final, so to speak. So it's not going to end up being so crazy. The only one that would be weird, I guess, would be Colorado-Montreal, would certainly feel strange. But we'll see. That's certainly possible. But yeah, had to jump on and discuss what is really just a story that will not go away, and that is the Toronto Maple Leafs continuing to choke and not having any bit of playoff success. And so with that, now the first round is complete, and we will see what gives for what already looks like a very interesting second round.